Hi guys, I'm Randy with BRStv, and today we're exploring the highly successful Zeovit system from Korallen Zucht and how it's likely more easy to implement on your tank than you may have thought. Today we'll cover just what the system is, options for utilizing it on your tank, how to get it started, and steps to keep the system on track. If you're looking for a tried and true system of controlling nutrients while also supplementing coral nutrition, trace and minor elements, with over a decade of proven results on absolutely stunning reef tanks, then look no further than the Zeovit system from Korallen Zucht. This two-tiered system of using zeolites and organic carbon dosing to bolster specific beneficial bacteria to create a low nutrient environment that is then supplemented with targeted coral foods and amino acids has been a successful way to create amazing tanks, which is evident by the dedicated Zeovit community and the tanks they keep. Even us here at BRS were so impressed by the reefing community's ability to repeat the same results in their own tanks that we exclusively use the entire Zeovit system in our very own BRS160 for roughly 2 years with the same solid results. One of our favorite parts of using the system was that the daily maintenance and dosing requirements kept us uniquely in tune with the tank so we could easily identify if and when something didn't look right. And since the daily tasks only take just a couple of minutes to complete, it makes it very easy to add to your daily schedule. To get your tank started on the Zeovit system, you really only need four basic components, which are the zeolite media, zeoback, zeofood, and zeostart. The zeolite media not only houses specific strains of beneficial bacteria which make up the zeoback component, but they also have the ability to absorb specific ammonia compounds within the tank before they're converted into nitrite and nitrate. Zeoback is a solution of several different bacterial strains and does have a limited shelf life, so most reefers keep the solution refrigerated and only keep a supply that can be used within 3 months. The Zeostart component is the fuel source for the nitrifying bacteria, which helps to promote their reproduction, while the Zeofood serves primarily as a fuel source for corals in the tank, all of which are dosed through the tank at a regularly scheduled basis. Finally, you'll also need activated carbon, which is recommended to be used in a media bag rather than a reactor to help filter pigments and toxins that may be present within the tank, as well as a method to house the zeolite media, such as using a Zeovit reactor like these. There are a few accessories available that can help to get the Zeovit system running on your tank, as well as ease some of the daily tasks while using it over time. As I mentioned earlier, you will need some sort of reactor to house the zeolite media, which will have to be pumped or shaken daily. With that in mind, there's a few options out there like these cost-effective reactors from Skims, Vertex reactors with an appropriately sized feed pump included, the very popular KZ magnetic reactor, which utilizes reversed magnets at the bottom for easier pumping, and the Vibe automatic reactors from Avast Marine that have a built-in vibrating motor, which you can set to a timer or controller to automatically shake the media for you. You could also hook the Zeostart component up to a dosing pump to help you manage its specific dosing requirements without needing to do it manually. In this case, really any dosing pump would do, but since there's fairly specific dosing requirements, choosing one that is accurate and reliable may be the best way to go. We found the easiest way to dose the Zeostart from a dosing pump was to DIY the bottle into its own dosing container by carefully drilling a hole in the lid and using a Murlock bulkhead and some acrylic tubing. Lastly, although some KZ bottles include droppers built into their lids, depending on the size of bottles for those without a dropper, picking up a graduated cylinder or dosing syringes like these can help to make sure you're providing the most accurate dose for your tank. Let's talk about setting up and using the Zeovit system on your tank. Whether you're starting Zeovit on a brand new setup, implementing it on an already established one, or maintaining the Zeovit system after it's been successfully implemented on your tank, there's only four basic components to keep up with, and each situation has its own set of dosing instructions. With that in mind, you can find all of those specific dosing instructions on KZ's online Zeovit guide, which we have linked in nearly every KZ product on the site. Regardless of your tank's dosing requirements, KZ also recommends that you have adequate skimming and use activated carbon to help export contaminants and pollutants in the water. Conduct regular weekly water changes to provide a balanced source of additional elements. Maintain optimal water parameters for major elements like alk, calcium, magnesium, and salinity, as well as provide sufficient flow and lighting to support your specific coral type needs. One thing to note here, the Zeovit system is specifically utilized for nutrient control and some coral nutrition, but does not include a supplement for major elements like alkalinity, calcium, and magnesium, so you may need to dose them on your own using a method of your choice. Once you have Zeovit up and running on your tank from using the startup guide, you can move on to using the dosing instructions for maintaining the system over time. Starting with the zeolite media, you'll first want to give it a quick rinse in RODI water to remove any dusty fines, then add it to your reactor. To find out how much you need, just use the recommendation of a 1-liter bag per every 100 gallons of water as a starting point. With the media in your reactor, you can begin the initial dose of the 3 bottles, ZeoBack, ZeoFood, and ZeoStart. I say initial dose for these bottles as your dosage of the first 2 bottles, ZeoBack and ZeoFood, will be slightly different for the first 2 weeks after a media change. Keeping that in mind for the first 2 weeks, you'll want to dose 1 drop per 25 gallons every 3 days, then after that initial 2-week period, simply dose them only twice each week. The third bottle, ZeoStart, is super simple to dose at the maintenance stage and only requires you to dose continuously at about 1 to 2 mils per 250 gallons every day, which is where the larger bottle and dosing pump can really help to automate this task. That's it. The only thing to do after that is to pump the zeolite media every day about 10 to 15 times to release the mold buildup on the surfaces, or set an automatic reactor like the Avast Marine Vibe to do it for you, and do a full media replacement once every 6 to 8 weeks. Moving on to maintenance of the Zeovit system, there's not much to it except for following the process of changing out new zeolite media and monitoring your nutrient levels. In order to keep the reactor working for you over time, cleaning it during the media exchanges is a great way to keep it operating smoothly for easy mold removal, as well as to keep it free from major clogs. Outside of daily dosing those 3 bottles and media changes, keeping up with weekly water changes, swapping out your carbon every 30 days, and maintaining your major element water parameters like alkalinity, calcium, magnesium, and salinity should get you on that path to a stunning KZ tank that you see from many other Zeovit users. Finally, there are several popular additions to the Zeovit system that some reefers use along with the basic 4, and deciding which ones you should use should reflect what goals you have for your tank. With that said, there are specific trace and minor element solutions that are designed to bring out specific colors like pink and red from KZ's B Balance, or for specific growth and color like the KZ Coral Booster. Also, since Zeovit creates a very low nutrient system, many reefers opt to specifically refuel the corals with additional food and amino acid supplements, much like we did for the BRS160 by using LPS amino acid concentrate, coral vitalizer, and the standard amino acid concentrate. Thanks for watching, and if you have any more questions that we didn't answer here, feel free to give us a call, send us an email, or hop on a chat. See you next time on BRStv.